This is the fourth video of the series, The Chemical Basis of Life. In the previous video, which I highly recommend you watch before this video, we have explained the concepts of acids, bases, pH scale, and buffers, and we have gone through the mechanism in which buffers work. Now, let us move on to talk about how pH is regulated in cells. pH regulation occurs at both cellular and systemic levels in multicellular organisms. First, why should cells regulate their pH value? Let us assume that pH is not regulated appropriately in cells, so what we can expect to see in these cells? Impaired protein structure. Impaired enzymatic function. Disturbance in the double helix structure of DNA. Disturbing the balance of ions within the cell, which affects osmotic pressure and cellular volume. Impaired energy production and compromised cellular respiration in mitochondria. Disrupting cell signaling cascades because its altered pH can affect the conformation of receptors and signaling molecules. Alteration in membrane fluidity and integrity, which affects cellular transport processes. Cellular stress. Fortunately, individual cells have mechanisms to regulate their internal pH. This involves the use of intracellular buffers, ion transporters, and enzymes that can influence the concentration of hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions within the cell. Cells actively maintain their internal environment to support essential biochemical processes and ensure the proper functioning of cellular components. The body employs distinct buffer systems to regulate pH levels. Within cells, the intracellular phosphate buffer system plays a crucial role, using hydrogen phosphate system to maintain intracellular pH balance. On the extracellular front, the bicarbonate buffer system takes center stage, operating primarily in the bloodstream and extracellular fluids. Meanwhile, the protein buffer system demonstrates its versatility, functioning effectively in both intra and extracellular spaces. The cellular pH regulation occurs through different mechanisms. 1. Intracellular buffer system. For example, a phosphate buffer system. The phosphate buffer system plays a vital role in preventing large swings in pH within cells, ensuring that the internal environment remains within an optimal pH range for cellular processes. This system involves the equilibrium between the dihydrogen phosphate ion and hydrogen phosphate ion. In this case, dihydrogen phosphate is a weak acid because it can donate hydrogen ions. Meanwhile, the hydrogen phosphorate ion, which can accept hydrogen, acts as the conjugate base. In acidic conditions, where there is an increase in the concentration of hydrogen ions, the hydrogen phosphate ion tends to accept a proton, favoring the formation of dihydrogen phosphate. In basic conditions, where there is an excess of hydroxide ions which can react with the hydrogen ions on the right side of the equation. This reaction can result in the removal of hydrogen ions from the system. So, as you know, in reversible reactions, the system tend to compensate the reactant hydrogen ions. To do so, the dihydrogen phosphate ion dissociate into phosphate ion and hydrogen ion. The intracellular phosphate buffer system provides a dynamic mechanism for cells to resist changes in pH. B. Bicarbonate buffer system. This buffer works systematically in the body through the lungs, blood, and kidneys. This system involves the equilibrium between carbonic acid and bicarbonate ions. In this case, carbonic acid acts as a weak acid in the buffer system. At the same time, bicarbonate ions are the conjugated base that accepts the hydrogen ions. It is important to know that carbonic acid can easily dissociate into water and carbon dioxide. In acidic conditions, when there is an increase in the concentration of protons in blood, the equilibrium of the bicarbonate buffer system shifts to the left. So, the excess protons combine with bicarbonate ions to form carbonic acid, which dissociates into water molecules and carbon dioxide. Then lungs take a role in eliminating carbon dioxide by increasing the rate and depth of breathing, which is known as hyperventilation. As a result, carbon dioxide is expelled, helping reducing the acidity in the blood. In basic conditions, Here there's an excess of hydroxide ions in the bloodstream, making it alkaline. In response, the bicarbonate buffer system shifts to the right. The excess hydroxide ions react with bicarbonate ions to form water and carbonate ions. Lungs tend to accumulate carbon dioxide by decreasing the rate and depth of breathing, also known as hypoventilation. The accumulated carbon dioxide reacts with water, which leads to the formation of carbonic acid, contributing to the rightward shift in the bicarbonate buffer system equilibrium. In these conditions, in response to the excess alkalinity, the kidneys play a role in bicarbonate ion excretion and help maintain a balance. 2. Intracellular protein buffers. Intracellular protein buffers involve the presence of specific amino acids and their ionizable side chains within proteins, which can act as weak acids or bases. These amino acids play a crucial role in maintaining the intracellular pH by accepting or donating hydrogen ions. For example, histidine, aspartate, and glutamate can act as weak acids or bases. Histidine side chains can be protonated or deprotonated. So, it acts as a buffer by accepting or donating hydrogen ions based on the intracellular pH. Aspartate and glutamate side chains have a carboxyl group that can be deprotonated. So, they act as buffers by accepting protons under acidic conditions. 3. Ion transporters. Ion transport proteins play a crucial role in regulating the pH of cells by actively moving ions, particularly protons and hydroxide ions, across cell membranes. These proteins help maintain the internal pH within a narrow and optimal range for various cellular processes. One well-known ion transport protein involved in pH regulation is the sodium proton exchanger, NHE. NHE is a membrane protein found in the cell membrane of many cell types. It functions to exchange sodium ions for protons across the cell membrane. The direction of this exchange depends on the electrochemical gradients of sodium and protons. When the intracellular environment becomes too acidic due to an accumulation of protons, the sodium proton exchanger facilitates the extrusion of protons from the cell in exchange for sodium ions. This helps to raise the intracellular pH by removing excess protons. Conversely, when the intracellular environment becomes too alkaline and there is a need for an increase in acidity, the sodium proton exchanger can work in the opposite direction. It imports protons into the cell while exporting sodium ions, helping to lower the intracellular pH. Interestingly, each organelle in the cell has a specific pH range that is crucial for its structure and function. So, inside the cell, we have different compartments with different pH values. For example, lysosomes are acidic, while mitochondria are slightly alkaline. Ion transporters like ion channels and pumps are indeed crucial for pH maintenance in cells, and they regulate the movement of ions across cell membranes to regulate the balance of hydrogen ions and other ions within the intracellular and extracellular environments. For example, the proton pump, which actively pumps protons across membranes, creates an acidic environment within organelles such as lysosomes, endosomes, and the Golgi apparatus compared to the cytosol. At the same time, mitochondria depend on the electron transport chain to pump the protons actively across the inner mitochondrial membrane and maintain a slightly alkaline pH in the matrix. In the case of the plasma membrane, the sodium proton exchanger, NHE, exchanges sodium ions for protons across the cell membrane to prevent acidification of the cytosol. The nucleus also uses proton pumps and bicarbonate transporters to maintain the optimal pH environment for nuclear processes and DNA-related activities. This was everything for this video. Thank you for watching.